Recovery. How are you, beautiful people? I hope you had a good weekend. Welcome home. That's what this place is. It's home. Miami Lakes United Methodist Church. I can honestly say, the home to some of the best people I've ever known. Especially you, Jeremy. So, I'm sure at some point I'll get a lecture about anonymity and its many, many, many definitions. But for now, let's talk about this. Oh my. These have been the weeks of my moral accountability. For those of you who don't remember what that is or don't know what that is, when you work the steps of the plan, you come to step four after having acknowledged that you are not God. Step one. And that you need help. And that you have to allow that help to happen. So then you have to make a list. Oh, the list. Of everyone who's ever hurt you, how it made you feel, and what effect it had on your life. And everything you've ever done to hurt someone, the effect it had on their life and your life, and the repercussions. It's called a moral accountability. And folks, it ain't no joke. And this is where I'm at. So if you don't mind, I'd like to share, not the details, but some of the process that I'm going through. See, I didn't want to do it. I mean, consciously, I wanted to do it. But I always found some excuse or another to not do it. I mean, any little thing. Oh yeah, I can't do that today. There's a bird on my windowsill. I gotta look at it. Or whatever. I didn't want to do it. I put up resistance. But then my accountability partner, who happens to be my pastor, said, it's time. You've been putting this off. So I sat down and started writing. And I didn't want to do it. And y'all know what I'm talking about. I had to go back to that time. To that place. When I did those things, like some kind of fool. And I have to take responsibility for the choices I made. And I gotta relive it, because how else can I write it if I'm not there again? And my brain is a genius at forgetting these things. I'll remember every moment where I came off looking like a pretty smart guy, but I forget every moment where I've been the villain of the story. It's like it never happened. But I'm 54 years old, and I'm a normal, everyday man, and sometimes I was the villain of the story. And it hurts me to think about the people I've hurt, the lives I affected. I didn't want to do it. And so I resisted writing. For 45 minutes, I stared at the paper after writing about one page, I just stared at it. I just resented the paper. But then you remind yourself why you're doing this. So I took out my phone, I opened my Hope Miami Lakes United Methodist Church app, because it has a Bible. The Hope app is free, and it has a Bible, and it speaks to you the verses, it reads them off to you. You can just have it playing in the background. It's kind of awesome. But I was reading. In the book of John. And in the word, the truth came to me. I resisted the process. I resisted the idea of sitting down and doing it. I was resisting it every step of the way. And that afternoon, that moment, it was a microcosm for my entire life. You see, my resistance is the problem. Give me an amen if you feel me. That's you too. I talk a pretty good game when it comes to surrender. But I haven't surrendered. I want to. I love Jesus with all my heart. I don't want to be wrong about back then, about now. I don't want to be wrong. Clearly, I was wrong, but I don't want it to be true. It can't be true. Because if it's true, who am I? And then that brings me to what the Word revealed. I am a son of God. I'm a new creation. I am forgiven. That's what God says about me, but that is not what I say about me. That's why I need Celebrate Recovery, because I have not forgiven me. And until I forgive myself, I'm no good to anybody. I'm on a loop. I'll do it again. Until I acknowledge that I have a king, and he's in charge. And what my king says is the law. So if he says, I am fearfully and wonderfully made, then that's what I am. I'm not the things that I whisper to myself, that the enemy whispers to me when I remember my failings, my habits, and my hang-ups, and the mistakes of my youth. I'm not a loser. I'm not pathetic. I'm not hopeless. I'm a child of God. I resist change. I always have. But what came to me in the Word this week, it's that it's not the specifics of what I'm changing. It's what I'm changing into. Let's worship. This lovely lady by my side is the beautiful Vivian Ortega. She will be. Thank you, anonymous person. Let's worship. If you'd like to stand, that would be great. If you'd like to clap and sing along, that would be so amazing. Join us. Let's worship God. Let's give thanks. He is worthy of our praise. I meet with you, and my soul sings out as your word flows down far away. I sing to you, and my heart cries holy, hallelujah, Father, you are near. grace. I worship you and my heart cries glory. Alleluia, Father, you are near. My hope is in you, Lord, all the day long. I won't be shaken by trial or storm. A peace that passes understanding is my song, and I sing. Well, my hope is in you, Lord. I will wait on you. You are my refuge. I will wait on you. You are my refuge. My hope is in you, Lord, all the day long. I won't be shaken by drought or storm. Declare it. My hope is in you, Lord, all the day long. I won't be shaken by drought or storm. A peace that passes understanding is my song, and I sing. My hope is in above all things. His love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise.
In the mighty hand and outstretched arm, his love endures forever. For the life that's been reborn, his love,
his love endures forever.
Sing
strong. Forever God is with us. Forever, forever, forever.
God is faithful, forever God is strong.
is with us forever, forever, forever. God is faithful forever. God is strong forever. God is with us forever, forever.
All these pieces broken and scattered, in mercy gathered, mended and told. Empty handed but not forsaken, I've been set free, I've been set free.
See you now. raising up the broken.